welcome everybody to the great state of Maine. We gather here this blissfully warm, almost autumn afternoon overlooking York Harbor to celebrate the gift of love. Bobby and Lizzie wish to commit themselves to one another. We come together to share with them their joy and their happiness as they begin this new chapter of their life together. I especially want to welcome Bobby and Lizzie's family and friends, you who have raised and have known them over the years. We have gathered from Kentucky, Illinois, Colorado, Washington, Missouri, or maybe Missouri, Connecticut, and Wisconsin. Both Bobby and Lizzie are grateful to you all that you have traveled this far and that you choose to share this day with them. Bobby and Lizzie, in your life together, you will be offering yourselves to each other. In one another's company, you will grow as separate persons. And in one another's company, you will grow as a couple. True love calls us out of isolation and separateness, even as we retain our identity as persons. The love you share is based on a mutual commitment to find meaning and to be companions in life. Lizzie and Bobby, members of your families join you today. In celebration of the love of family, who presents this woman to be married to this man? Nice and loud so we can hear.
It's hard. We do.
Perfect. Before we say more about love, it is important to recognize the source of love in our lives. When Bobby and Lizzie came into the world, someone loved and cared for them. Someone showed them what love and compassion and kindness and care truly are. I speak of their parents. The work of our parents is central in preparing all of us to be loving adults. And so today, Bobby and Lizzie wish to recognize their parents. Thank you, Mark and Joni, Joe and Marcia. At this time, Lizzie and Bobby would like to take a moment to remember special people in their lives who are not here with us today, but who live on in our hearts. Lizzie's maternal grandparents, Vance and Bonnie Graybill. Lizzie's paternal grandparents, Charlie and Fran Souza. Bobby's maternal grandparents, Lee and Penny Cheetick. Bobby's paternal grandparents, Zygmunt and Ruth Goodman. Lizzie and Bobby have asked me to say a few words about marriage and about them. And you will not be surprised to know that I am delighted to do so. I am torn between two important aspects of this day, each of which could serve to launch my reflections. First, you come from different religious backgrounds. Lizzie, Roman Catholic. Bobby, Jewish. At root, Roman Catholicism is sacramental and individual, emphasizing ritual. Baptism, confirmation, First Communion, the Eucharist. Judaism, on the other hand, is communal and family-oriented, emphasizing story and history and tradition. You know, tradition! That's what I was thinking. Your religious backgrounds are reflected today by including a Catholic prayer following sharing your rings, by breaking a glass at the very end of the ceremony, and by our standing here under, almost, a chuppah. In Jewish tradition, the chuppah symbolizes the home, four poles, and sometimes a cloth canopy, although I'm told that this is, in fact, a canopy. The chuppah is open on all four sides, representing hospitality to all guests. And you may have noticed it lacks furniture. As a reminder that the basis of the Jewish home is people and family, not possessions. So all y'all are welcome. This chuppah reminds us that the foundation of marriage is spiritual. Individual and communal. Now, there is a theme for a homily on marriage. And understandably, you might think I would choose this interfaith aspect to launch my reflections. But I choose another. For we are in Maine. Also a metaphor for your life together. Maine topography with its wide open ocean, broad vistas and distant horizons, with its stretches of pine forests and large, clear, still lakes up north and west, invite me to rhapsodize about all things horizontal, about vision and distance, the long view, the big picture. At the same time, the mountains to the north and west, with their challenging trails and rushing streams, and this rocky coastline, with its tidal pools, invite our attention to life's myriad details. A healthy marriage is inspired by a long view of what can be a more just and content place for ourselves and for our world. It is at once holding high a vision of something more, something deeper, something extraordinary, which enlivens the ordinary. It is holding firm to principle, living with honesty and integrity and courage, exhibiting strength of character and perseverance and resilience. A healthy marriage holds the big picture in its scope, giving context to and shaping our experience of daily life. You have done that for each other, unwavering and encouraging in your support and care, grounded in patience, even when it is not quite your initial feeling. You whet each other's curiosity, helping each other grow into your best selves. Together, you celebrate your good fortune at simply being alive and having each other to love. At the same time, while always affirming the expansive perspective, it is truly the details and the immediacies of life that are the building blocks of strength and resilience. Maine's topography requires that we take care and pay attention. While we look up to gain perspective, we also look down to notice the little things, taking nothing for granted. It's the same in marriage. We build a healthy marriage by sharing a mass of daily details and reveling in the immediacy of shared experiences. You have consistently lured each other into laughter and delight and joy. You notice and nurture and honor daily life up close. Your animal kids, Baxter and Lottie, and the songs you sing about them and to them. In fact, animals of all sorts, including Whole Foods gummy zoo animals. And while we're on food, Lizzie's love of Halo ice cream while watching Lifetime Network movies. And how about Bobby's passion for numbers and facts and economic trends? Lizzie's dance moves. Biannual shopping for Bobby. Bobby's intense joy when the Cubbies won the World Series.
All right.
Go Cubbies.
Go Cubbies.
Lizzie's distaste for bugs. Picking apples and pumpkins. And of course, fun Bobby's massive and generous smile. Yours too, Lizzie. Daily life up close is much more fun when you are together. In a healthy marriage, vistas and details are woven together. Your daily experiences are equally important to your vision. The mundane is what gives life its shine, its sweetness, its sparkle, and its joy. It is taking pleasure in what gives your partner pleasure. Alone time for Lizzie when you, Bobby, just want to hang with friends. Encouraging Lizzie to start her own practice. Lizzie's conversion into a Cubs fan who now knows more about the team and its players than Bobby.
That's true.
A dog person welcoming Baxter the cat into his home a year before he welcomed Lizzie. You complement each other, a go-getter extrovert and a laid-back introvert. And you appreciate that about each other. One of my colleagues, Robert Fulgham, wrote, "We're all a little weird, and life is weird. And when we find someone whose weirdness is compatible with our own, we join up with them and fall into mutually satisfying weirdness. And we call it love, true love." You know that the journey into marriage takes patience and resilience. Sometimes the journey towards the far horizon of justice and a better world is akin to sailing through a storm. When you are exhausted, grit, determination, and a well-oiled sense of humor are often our best allies. That you have. When you are tired and stressed, a supportive and affirming companion is a blessing. That you have. When you experience challenges, a set of shared core values is fundamental. That you have. In marriage, we are witnesses to each other all the time, every day, so that neither of you need play to an empty house. You share your baggage and help each other put down what must be put down, let go of what must be let go of, and revel in all that's invites and celebration. A healthy marriage is that place where our gifts meet the gifts of another, creating a union that is much, much more than simply two persons. Surrounded here by the people you care most about, today you are exactly where you are meant to be. Lizzie, you are marrying a man who is devoted to you, a sports fan with incredible energy, who works hard and with a clear sense of direction, whose self-confidence is humble and quiet, and who is selfless in every way. That's Bobby. And Bobby, you're marrying a girl from Kentucky who inspires you, who makes you laugh, who keeps you in check,
yeah.
who makes you want to be better every day, who calms you, who melts your heart. Who would have thought? From Kentucky. That's Lizzie. May both of you continue to inspire one another to be your best selves. May your dreams and details inform each other. May you be wholly alive to yourself and to each other. And may your marriage be filled with grace, with peace, and with joy.
Did I do okay?
Fuck yeah. Good job, good job. I know you were getting hot there.
Weddings are a time of pride and hope and memory and even a touch of sadness. But above all, weddings are a time of great joy and love. From these feelings come the best wishes of your families and your friends. To all here gathered, motorcycles up there. With joy and with love, do you bless Bobby and Lizzie, wishing them the best in their life together? If so, say loudly, we do. And so I ask.
Your hands are so cold, hon. I need to warm them. Sorry.
Do you, Bobby, take Lizzie as your wife? Do you promise to love and respect her? Comfort her. Support her. And honor this commitment to each other as long as you both shall live? If so, please say, I do.
I do. All day long, yeah.
And do you, Lizzie, take Bobby as your husband? Do you promise to love and to respect him? Comfort him. Support him. And honor this commitment to each other as long as you both shall live? If so, say as loud as you can, I do.
I do.
Look at you.
And now, in the tradition of the Roman Catholic Church, I ask you to stand as Lizzie and Bobby say their vows to each other.
Which one of you goes first? Doesn't matter.
I'll go first because okay. I'll be crying.
Oh, yeah.
I'm
going to
go.
So
I know.
I know. I'm a girl.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to give you a microphone.
Okay.
I'll hold it if it needs to.
Do you want to hold it? I'm going to hold it. Doesn't matter.
Bobby, I'm not sure my words can express how honored and lucky I feel to be standing next to you on our wedding day, or across from you. You are an extraordinary compliment to my soul. You are the dream of my life and an inspiration to my dates. I love you as a human, as my best friend, and soon as my husband. I respect you, adore you, and I am in complete awe of you. I promise to believe in you, not just the you today, but in the man you have yet to become and in the world you have yet to create. I promise to love you without fear or uncertainty, as you have loved me so easily. I promise to be the strength to your weakness, the emotion to your intellect, and the calm to your storm. I promise to take more risks and trust the adventures that you have helped me to embrace. I promise to stand beside you through sickness and through failure, through health and through triumph. I promise to always learn from you, whether it's the rules of baseball or how to put my feelings first. I promise to listen intently to the details of your days, your months, and your years. As your life will not go unnoticed because I will notice it, and your life will not go unwitnessed because I will be your witness. I promise to always be your partner, your companion, your friend, and your mentor in this life and life beyond the walls of heaven. For one lifetime with you could never be enough. I give you all that I have and all that I am. These are my sacred vows to you, my love, for the rest of our days.
Do you want the microphone? Do you want the microphone?
You sure? You need it.
Okay.
That was so good. Lizzie, as we stand here committing to share the rest of our lives together, I am completely present in this moment. Today is the happiest day of my life. I get to marry my dream girl. Life carved out a circuitous path for us to find each other. I wake up every morning knowing I'm the luckiest man in the world for what we share. We have such a special relationship. Somehow, we always know what the other is thinking and feeling. Our connection is natural, intuitive, unspoken, and unbreakable. Time after time, we demonstrate our ability to accomplish anything together. I'm excited to see where our journey takes us together. I promise to always be your best friend. There's no one else I want to navigate life with. I promise to love you through all of life's peaks and valleys. Our love withstands any bumpy road. I promise to say I love you each day and night, before going to bed and upon waking up each morning. I promise to put you and our family, furry or human, above all else. I will always do what's best for our team. I promise to keep life fun and exciting. There will never be a dull moment in our journey together. I promise that my eyes will light up every time you walk into a room. Each time I see you, you're somehow more beautiful than the last. I promise to support your goals and dreams. I will be the helping hand to ensure you reach the top each time. I promise to catch you when you fall. I am your safety net. I promise you of my enduring love and loyalty. I'm your guardian angel and protector. I promise to love you forever because you are my soulmate. I give you all that I have and all that I am. These are my sacred vows to you, my love, for the rest of our days.
Please be seated.
Good. You want to sit down too?
The wedding ring is an outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual bond which unites two loyal hearts in love. I invite you now to give and receive your ring, saying, Lizzie, take this ring as a sign of my constant faith and abiding love.
Lizzie, take this ring as a constant sign of my abiding faith and endless love.
Close enough.
Yeah, I figured.
Go ahead.
It's pretty.
Let's bend that finger a little bit. There we go.
To repeat it.
Bobby, take this ring.
Bobby, take this ring.
As a sign of my constant faith.
As a sign of my constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love. Thank you.
Good stuff.
May we have some moments for prayer. We thank you, O God, for the love you have implanted in our hearts. May it always inspire us to be kind in our words, considerate of feeling, and concerned for each other's needs and wishes. Help us to be understanding and forgiving of human weaknesses and failings. Increase our faith and trust in you, and may your prudence guide our life and our love. Bless this marriage, O God, with peace and with happiness, and make our love fruitful for your glory and our joy, both here and in eternity. Amen. In Jewish tradition, breaking a wine glass serves to remind us of two central aspects of marriage. First, marriage vows are irrevocable, just as permanent and final as breaking this glass is irrevocable. And second, marriage, like glass, is fragile. Marriage needs our attention, our commitment, and our protection. Bobby and Lizzie, knowing this, always strive to show each other love and respect. I think you got that one down. Our prayer is that your lives together will be longer than it would take to fit pieces of broken glass back together again. At the very end of our ceremony, immediately after they kiss, Bobby and Lizzie will break the glass, and I invite everyone to shout loudly, Mazel Tov, meaning good luck and congratulations. And now, by the authority vested in me, yes, I declare that Bobby,
you,
and Lizzie are joined together in marriage that is both recognized and cherished by God, by this community, and by the state of Maine. May your days be long upon the earth, and may you dwell in love together. You shall go out in joy and be led forth in peace. The mountains and the hills before you shall break forth into singing, and all the trees of the field shall clap their hands. You may kiss.
Huh?